Our unemployment rate has fallen from a peak of 10% in 2009 when I first came into office. First and foremost, it's the direct result of you, the drive and determination of the American people. But I'm going to take a little credit.
That was President Obama giving himself a pat on the back for the improving economy. But do Americans agree with his assessment? We have some new poll numbers to share with you. Let's debate them with CNN political commentator and Republican strategist Tara Stetmeyer, along with CNN political commentator and Democratic strategist Paul Begala. Paul is the senior advisor for the Super PAC Priorities USA Action. And before we get to politics, Paul, you gave us quite a scare when we heard you were in a hospital in Israel.
I was. I had an appendectomy. It all went great. The Israeli healthcare is fantastic, by the way. If you ever have to have emergency surgery, I recommend Tel Aviv Medical Center.
Wow. Well, you look great. How you feeling?
And you guys sent flowers, by the way. New Day. My mom didn't even send flowers. She's like, oh, you'll be fine. There they are. Thank you. That is so gracious. I mean it.
I'm sure you love seeing yourself in a hospital gown there on national television. It's great to have you back. All right, Tara, let's talk about these fresh polls that have just been released this hour. I want to show you how Americans think the country is doing right now. This is interesting and telling. 53% of the country thinks that the country is doing well. 46% think they're doing badly. What's interesting is that when President Obama took office, February of 2009, only 21% thought it was doing well. 79% thought the country was doing badly. What do you make of these?
Well, most people know, and Paul will attest to this, that polls are a snapshot in time. It's how people feel at the moment when they're asked the question. So whether it's about perception. So whether that's actually true, if the country's on the right track or not, doesn't matter. It's the perception. So sure, when President Bush left office, we had a financial crisis. People were upset about the war in Iraq. So President Obama ushered in supposed to be this new hope and change. So people felt a little bit better. As of right now, I mean, you know, this poll is over 50% on this a little bit, but it's just for right now because people think, oh, the unemployment rate is down, so things must be good. Gas prices are down, and things must be good.
Sure.
But that's not actually the truth of the matter of the health of our economy or what's really going on in the country or what's going on in the world as far as American leadership is concerned. So perception and reality sometimes can be differently reflected in polls.
I mean, though they say perception is reality, if people are feeling more optimistic, then good things happen in the country, Paul.
Right. The economy is not something you can spin. I've tried. Okay, people live it, they experience it, and so they know, they don't think, they know how things are going. But this actually, as a strategist, is a much more important leading indicator than the horse race stuff. I mean, okay, we all do the horse race stuff. My gal Hillary's beating everybody by 100,000 points, that's baloney. Okay, that's useless.
As an aside.
As a strategist.
As an incidental aside
But what's important is this. Are we moving in the right direction or have things gotten off on the wrong track? Are things getting better or worse? Is the president doing well or the Republican Congress doing better? Those kind of indicators are much more important future predictors of where American politics is going.
Let's take a look at actually where the president is doing right now, because we have a poll on that also. The favorability rating right at 46%. Now, you might look at that and say, hey, look, he's under 50. Things aren't great. But look at it relative to where George W. Bush was, Tara, in March of 2007. And you see that you know, Bush obviously had huge problems, and it led to huge electoral difficulties for the Republicans in the following election. President Obama in a much different place.
I think that President Obama is much better at going out there giving speeches when it looks like things aren't going well. He'll go out and he'll give a big rah-rah campaign speech, make people feel good again, to deflect from what's actually going on.
So he's tricking people into thinking the economy is going well?
But what do you think the problems are?
Well, one of the biggest problems is the fact that we have an unbelievable debt going on here. It's doubled since Obama took office. More businesses are failing than are being started in this economy. The economy is not doing that well. It's recovering at a very slow rate, the slowest since the Great Depression. You have over 46 million people on food stamps, record numbers of people on disability. I mean, the government overreach going on in people's lives is awful, and that people don't feel them more specifically about how they feel about the economy and whether things are going well, the American people don't feel that positive about what's happening. So when I see a poll like this, or even unemployment, that's an inflated number. Unemployment being down, you know, 5.whatever% it is now, the labor participation rate is at a 37-year low. That's because people are dropping out of the workforce. But most people don't know that. They just see, oh, unemployment's at 5.7%.
Okay.
Things are going great.
It's not as rosy as it looks, Paul.
Right, but as Joe Biden says, don't compare us to the almighty, compare us to the alternative. You know, politics is a comparative business. The greatest political strategist ever was Henny Youngman. Anytime somebody asked him, how's your wife, he said, compared to what? Okay? How's the president compared to what? No, he's not perfect. Yes, there are problems. Tara mentions him, and we have to address them. But people are smart, and they make their own assessments. Like, how's he doing? He's been in there for 6 years. Okay, as a strategist looking forward to 2016, I can run with this guy leading my country. Okay, when Bush was president, poor John McCain was trying to win, and we tagged him as a third term of Bush. The Democrats carried every single state where Bush was below 35.
Let's put the Hennie-Youngman test.
I can run with this guy.
Let's talk about the Hennie-Youngman test right now, because compared to what? Compared to the Republican Congress, we talked about the President Obama's favorability of 46%. Let's look at the Republican Congress right now. The approval rating is 23%. Disapproval at 74%. Actually, I don't think 23% is as low as we've seen for Congress in the past, but still not high, Tara.
Yeah, but Congress is traditionally at a low rate. I think at one point the Republican Congress was down to 9% at one, you know, and when Nancy Pelosi was Speaker of the House, it was in low digits too. People just traditionally don't think Congress is great because people are frustrated with Washington. They think it's gridlock. People are fighting with each other, not getting anything done. So the perception of what's going on in Congress compared to the president, who has the bully pulpit, he has the ability to shape news where he wants to. He can create a it's a perception game. Like I said, it's messaging. Paul himself even just admitted that you could run with this guy with these kinds of numbers, not based on his record, but based on how you can
turn around.
You know what? I would love to see have a candidate with his record and the way that how horrible this country is doing, not only domestically but internationally. Let's run another third term of Barack Obama. Let's try that and see how that works in 2016.
But I mean, let's talk about 2016 because you know, to Paul's point, if it's Hillary Clinton, if she's the candidate, then it will be something of a third term. She was involved in this administration, and you're saying that's fine with you.
Well, she'll have her areas of separation, obviously, like everybody does. But the model here, the only time in our lifetime that a party got three in a row was Reagan to Bush. Now, Bush had served loyally for Ronald Reagan, Bush Sr., of course. But he also had his points of separation. I'll be kinder, gentler. You know, and I think that is, obviously, it's the only successful model in my lifetime. I think that's much more like it. I look at this, and of course, this super PAC that I helped run supported the president's reelection. So you know my biases, right? But still, just as somebody who wants Hillary to run and wants her to win, I can run with this guy. It's a good record, and it's only going to get better. I have to tell you, the economy is improving. The biggest thing is we've had great jobs reports for many months. We're finally getting some wage growth. That's the most important thing. If you see these, so, you know, our economics reporter is going to be more important than the political analyst. As wages start creeping up, man, it's going to be good for the Democrats.
Well, the Fed has their eye on it, obviously. It could be acting soon.
If they're honest about the economic report, I mean, the average family income has gone down under this president.
People aren't being honest about a lot of things when they're talking to pollsters. But, Tara, we're going to have to take that up another time. Tara St. Mary, thanks for being with us. Paul McGowan, great to have you with us.
Great to have you guys. Thanks so much. All right, we're following a lot of news this morning.